In today's world, as every second passes, we're going deeper into the digital age, surrounded by smartphones, computers, IoT devices, and so much more. But with all these electronic devices come threats. Threats that can compromise our personal and professional lives. From ransomware attacks shutting down entire cities to data breaches leaking your sensitive information, the internet can be a dangerous place without enough cybersecurity. But don't worry, that's exactly why we're here. Today, we're going to share some of the most important tips to increase your cybersecurity so that you can feel safe while using your latest gadgets. Let us start with the basics. When it comes to cybersecurity, the practice of regular updates serves a significant role. These updates to your operating system, software, and apps often bring not just new features, but critical patches for security vulnerabilities. In essence, every time you update, you're mitigating the potential entry points that cyber attackers can exploit. Layered upon this fundamental practice, the implementation of reputable antivirus and anti-malware software provides an extra shield, actively scanning and blocking malicious threats that might slip through. This multi-tiered defensive approach significantly fortifies your system's resilience. However, cyber protection isn't just about your system's defenses. It extends to your personal practices as well. Passwords serve as the keys to your digital life, so they must be robust and unique for each of your accounts. This prevents a breach from one platform from extending to others. Yet remembering a plethora of strong passwords can be a daunting task. That's where password managers step in. These secure digital vaults can handle that complexity for you, further enhancing your personal cybersecurity infrastructure. Next comes two-factor authentication, 2FA, a double-check mechanism to confirm it's really you trying to access your accounts. This function offers another layer of security, providing additional protection even if your password gets compromised. Apart from two-factor authentication, it is also important to regularly change your password. It can be an essential part of maintaining your cybersecurity health. These audits involve reviewing and updating your passwords on a consistent basis, similar to how you might regularly check your physical health. Cybersecurity experts often recommend using strong, unique passwords for each of your online accounts. This means that each password should be complex, using a mix of uppercase, lowercase letters, numbers, and special characters. More importantly, each password should be different from the others. This way, if one account gets compromised, the others remain secure. However, with the multitude of accounts we tend to have in this digital age, it can be challenging to keep track of all these passwords, much less update them regularly. This is where password managers can come in handy, helping you to store, manage, and update your passwords in a secure manner. However, cybersecurity practices aren't merely about proactive defense mechanisms. It's equally about vigilant behaviors. This includes being cautious about opening email attachments or clicking links from unfamiliar or untrusted sources, as these are common methods used in phishing attacks. Phishing, alongside other social engineering tactics, is a strategy wherein cybercriminals use deceit to trick individuals into surrendering sensitive information. Remaining alert to these tactics is crucial to safeguarding your digital domain. Now, let us focus on managing your network and online presence. You should always use a firewall and secure home network to keep out unwanted intruders. Regular data backups complement this by ensuring that even if a cyber incident occurs, your data remains safe, recoverable, acting as a safety net for your digital assets. When considering personal devices, maintaining physical control is just as crucial as digital security. Leaving devices unattended, even momentarily, can lead to unauthorized access or theft. Similarly, using a virtual private network or VPN while connecting to the internet, especially on public Wi-Fi networks, shields your online activities through encryption. This encrypted connection acts as a secure tunnel for your data, keeping it away from prying eyes. Staying proactive about your online account settings and conducting regular privacy and security audits helps to mitigate unnoticed vulnerabilities. In parallel, staying informed about the latest cyber threats provides the knowledge needed to recognize and avoid emerging dangers. Knowledge truly is power when it comes to cyber defense. Encryption of sensitive data ensures its confidentiality, adding another layer to your data security by rendering it unreadable to anyone without the correct encryption key. Concurrently, downloading apps and files solely from reputable sources reduces the risk of inadvertently installing malicious software. Personal information shared online can be a treasure trove for cybercriminals, potentially leading to identity theft. Therefore, limiting this sharing reduces your exposure. Public computers often lack adequate security measures, making them unsuitable for sensitive transactions like online banking or shopping. Regularly monitoring your credit reports and bank statements is analogous to a health checkup for your financial well-being. These documents contain important information about your financial transactions and can provide early indications of any unauthorized or suspicious activity. Just as regular health checkups can detect potential health issues before they become serious, regularly scrutinizing your financial statements can help you spot discrepancies or signs of identity theft that could lead to serious financial harm. For instance, you might notice unfamiliar charges on your bank statements or unexpected changes in your credit report, such as new accounts you didn't open or inquiries you didn't initiate. Such anomalies can indicate that a fraudster has gained access to your financial information. By identifying these signs early, you can report them to your financial institution or credit bureau, who can then take steps to investigate and resolve the issue, limiting the potential damage. Another important awareness is that you should always lock your devices when not in use and try to employ biometric security features, such as fingerprint or facial recognition. This offers an immediate layer of security, making unauthorized access even more difficult. Each of these steps, when implemented, enhances your overall cybersecurity measures, leading to a more secure digital experience. Virtual machines can serve as powerful tools in protecting your system from potential cybersecurity threats. Essentially, a virtual machine is a software application that emulates a physical computer system. It creates an isolated environment, often referred to as a sandbox, where you can perform tasks without affecting your main operating system. This can be particularly beneficial when it comes to activities that might be deemed risky. For instance, if you need to run a file that seems suspicious, doing so in the real-world environment of your main system can be a gamble. If the file is indeed malicious, it could compromise your system's security. Running the file within a virtual machine, however, can prevent this, as the VM operates separately from your main system. The same applies to visiting potentially risky websites. These sites may contain harmful scripts or attempt to install malware on your machine. If you visit these websites within a VM, any malicious activity is confined to the virtual environment and doesn't reach your actual operating system. We're just getting started and we have a lot more of these suggestions to offer you, so keep this video till the end and be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you won't miss a single tip. Now, let us concentrate on how you should manage your personal device to prevent hacking. When we talk about managing access to your devices, one common area to look at is the Remote Desktop Protocol, or RDP, and Bluetooth functionalities. RDP enables remote access to your device, which, while convenient for legitimate purposes, can also be exploited for unauthorized access. Similarly, Bluetooth can be a conduit for unsolicited connections or data transfer. Therefore, disabling both when not in use minimizes these potential vulnerabilities. Jailbreaking or rooting your phone, while providing more control and customization, strips away critical layers of security protocols, leaving your device more susceptible to malicious attacks. It's like removing the front door from your house. It may offer more freedom, but it also lets in any intruders easily. A significant aspect of any device hygiene is maintaining a lean set of applications and browser extensions. Over time, we tend to accumulate apps and extensions that we seldom use. Each of these can be a potential security loophole. Regular review and uninstallation of unnecessary ones helps to minimize this risk. Moreover, using a physical security key for two-factor authentication adds a physical barrier to your digital accounts, making them considerably harder to compromise. Public charging stations, while useful during a battery crunch, can be risky. They could be tampered with to deliver malware or siphon off data from your device, a tactic known as juice jacking. Maintaining device exclusivity and segregating personal devices from work usage also helps to prevent cross-contamination of data and inadvertent security compromises. Being proactive about checking for signs of malware, such as unexpected battery drain or performance slowdown, can provide early warning of a potential infection. Additionally, keeping an eye on your online reputation helps identify if your personal information is being misused online. Network hygiene, such as changing your Wi-Fi password regularly, can keep unauthorized users off your network. In the physical realm, using privacy screen protectors helps to thwart visual hacking attempts while you're using your device in public. They're like curtains for your digital windows, preventing prying eyes from looking in. While software firewalls are useful, a hardware firewall provides even stronger network security. It acts like a digital border control, scrutinizing all incoming and outgoing traffic for potential threats and blocking them. Incorporating these practices into your cybersecurity routine will significantly boost the security posture of your personal devices, providing a safer digital environment for you. Many cyber attackers use different malicious websites and unwanted emails and pop-ups for hacking into your systems. So you should always be careful with your browsers and what websites you visit. Online safety significantly depends on the conscientious use of websites and browsers. When participating in online transactions, it's important to use secure websites that provide encryption, evident by the https://// prefix in their URL. This ensures the confidentiality of your data. For online shopping or auctions, it's safer to only engage with reputable sellers, and be wary of online advertisements and pop-up ads as they can be laced with malware or lead to scam websites. Account security isn't just about having a strong password. It also entails setting up robust recovery options and using non-public information for security questions, making it harder for potential attackers to hijack your account. Using encrypted messaging apps and secure browsers can further safeguard your digital communications from unauthorized access. A good practice is to disable your autofill on your browser, as it can expose sensitive information if someone else gains access to your device. The feature that automatically previews emails in your inbox can be a double-edged sword when it comes to security. While it provides convenience by allowing you to quickly glance at the content of an email without fully opening it, it can also unintentionally execute malicious scripts embedded in the email. Malicious emails often contain harmful code that gets triggered when the email is viewed. This code can do a variety of things, such as installing malware on your device or forcing your email client to send information back to the sender, revealing that your email account is active and making it a potential target for future attacks. Turning off the preview feature in your email client adds a layer of security by preventing these automatic scripts from running without your full awareness and consent. This way, you can choose to open only those emails that you trust or consider important, reducing the risk of inadvertently triggering malicious code. Additionally, consider using a separate, dedicated email account specifically for financial transactions. This way, even if your main email account is compromised, your financial information remains secure. It's also essential to regularly clear your browser's cache and cookies. This practice can both protect your online privacy by erasing traces of your online activities and maintain optimal browsing speed. If you are using cloud services for backups, ensure that the service provides robust encryption for your data. This protects your data from being readable even if it falls into the wrong hands. For online viewing in public, privacy screen protectors can be a useful tool. These limit the viewing angles of your device screen, preventing others from shoulder surfing and seeing sensitive information. Another security measure could be the use of a hardware firewall for enhanced network security, creating a more robust line of defense compared to software firewalls. By carefully adopting these practices, you can significantly enhance your online safety, particularly when using websites and browsers. Taking care of cybersecurity extends beyond browsers and websites, reaching into the element like files, apps, and device sensors as well. When it comes to file deletion, it's crucial to understand that simply pressing delete often doesn't completely erase the file from your system. It's like removing the table of contents from a book. The chapters are still there. Secure file deletion tools go a step further, ensuring that deleted files can't be recovered, thereby safeguarding your sensitive data even after it's discarded. Another layer of security can be added through DNS filtering services. By blocking known harmful domains, these services prevent access to malicious websites, acting like a vigilant watchtower against cyber threats. The number of apps with camera and microphone permissions should be diligently kept to a minimum. These permissions can potentially be misused to spy on you. It's akin to allowing someone to peep through your windows. Best to keep those permissions only for apps that absolutely need them. Similarly, limit the use of location services. While they can provide useful functionalities, many apps can track your location. potentially infringing upon your privacy. It's like leaving digital breadcrumbs everywhere you go. Therefore, only essential apps should be given this privilege. It's crucial to thoroughly understand user agreements when downloading apps, much like reading a contract before signing it. App user agreements, also known as terms of service or end user license agreements, essentially set out the legal guidelines for what you can do and cannot do with the app. They also detail what the app can do with your data, which is particularly important for preserving your privacy. These agreements often contain clauses about data collection, usage, and sharing policies. Some apps may collect extensive information, including your location, contact list, browsing history, or even the content of your messages. They may use this data for their functioning, but in some cases they could also share it with third parties for marketing or other purposes. By understanding the user agreement, you become aware of such practices and can make an informed decision about whether or not to use the app based on your comfort level with its data handling policies. Lastly, consider using an ad blocker. Not only can it enhance your online experience by preventing intrusive ads, but it also keeps you safe from potentially malicious ads that might lead to harmful websites or downloads. By incorporating these considerations and practices, you can fortify your cybersecurity defenses, particularly in the context of apps and device sensors, thereby providing a more secure digital environment for yourself. All of the above measures that we have discussed can be useless if you don't have enough knowledge about cybersecurity. Cyber attackers will be continuously inventing new ways to get into your system. Only proper knowledge can save you from this. Thus, staying up to date on the latest developments in cybersecurity can equip you with the knowledge to identify and combat these threats effectively. This could include following cybersecurity blogs, participating in online security webinars, or even taking cybersecurity courses. Much like a well-trained soldier who is always prepared for changing battle scenarios, an individual well-informed about the latest cyber threats is better positioned to protect their digital environment. On the other hand, it's important to cultivate a healthy level of skepticism, especially regarding unsolicited tech support calls and email scams. Cybercriminals often exploit human trust and curiosity to launch attacks, a practice known as social engineering. They may pose as tech support personnel or send scam emails, tricking victims into revealing sensitive information or downloading malware. By being vigilant and wary of such unsolicited communications, you can better protect yourself from these tactics. It's much like not opening your door to a stranger who claims to be a maintenance worker without verifying their credentials first. Remember, the first line of defense in cybersecurity is often not a piece of software, but an informed and cautious user. Finally, you can also use cybersecurity insurance in order to cover the costs associated with a data breach or cyber attack. Cybersecurity insurance generally provides coverage for a range of expenses that may occur as a result of a digital attack. These could include the costs of investigating the breach, business losses from network downtime, public relations efforts to manage reputational damage, and legal fees associated with potential lawsuits or regulatory fines. One crucial aspect of cybersecurity insurance that makes it particularly valuable is the support it provides in the aftermath of a breach. For example, most policies offer assistance with notifying customers impacted by the breach and providing credit monitoring services for them. Some even cover the cost of ransom payments in case of a ransomware attack. And there you have it. Cybersecurity is a pivotal necessity in our ever-increasing digital landscape, and in this digital era, staying secure is not merely an option, but an imperative. We are also looking forward to your valuable input in the comment box regarding your thoughts on the feasibility and importance of incorporating these cybersecurity measures into your daily routine. Thank you for tuning in, and we look forward to bringing you more vital updates and insightful analyses in the future.